From 1945 to 1990, the evolution of aircraft carriers became the story of technology, power, and global influence at sea. At the end of the Second World War, ships like HMS Glory and HMS Triumph of the United Kingdom reflected a transition from wartime mass production to early jet age experimentation. These light carriers, with their straight decks and compact designs, carried piston engine and the first jet aircraft, bridging two eras of aviation. France followed with Aeromanche, marking the rebirth of its navy, while the Netherlands introduced HNLMS Carol Dorman, proving that smaller nations could also project air power. The United States entered the Cold War with massive steel giants like USS Coral Sea and USS Hancock, evolving from wooden decks to reinforced steel surfaces for heavier jet aircraft. By the early 1950s, the Royal Navy launched HMS Eagle, a true symbol of post-war naval might. While the United States introduced USS Forrestal in 1955, the first supercarrier and blueprint for all that followed. France advanced again with Clemenceau in 1957, sleek and efficient. While Canada's HMCS Bonaventure joined NATO's growing carrier fleet. Brazil's Minas Gerais showed that carrier technology was spreading worldwide. In the early 1960s, ships like USS Kitty Hawk and USS America represented the height of American Cold War engineering, their immense decks hosting Phantom and Intruder jets. The Royal Navy's HMS Hermes embraced new designs, with an angled deck and later a ski jump ramp, adapting to vertical takeoff aircraft. France continued refining the Clemenceau design, while the United States unveiled USS John F. Kennedy in 1968, a towering steel fortress symbolizing unmatched naval dominance. The arrival of USS Nimitz in 1972 changed everything. Nuclear power gave carriers near endless range, while its vast deck became home to advanced Tomcat fighters. Meanwhile, the Soviet Union challenged the West with Kiev in 1973, a hybrid between carrier and missile cruiser, emphasizing versatility and defense. Italy's Giuseppe Garibaldi project of 1975 and Britain's HMS Invincible in 1976 introduced compact designs optimized for vertical takeoff jets and helicopters, showing that even small carriers could deliver strategic impact. The nuclear-powered USS Dwight D. Eisenhower in 1978 reinforced America's dominance, while France began envisioning its own nuclear vessel, the future Charles de Gaulle. The 1980s brought refinement and power. USS Carl Vinson, USS Theodore Roosevelt, and USS Abraham Lincoln continued the nuclear legacy, each a floating airbase capable of global projection. Britain's HMS Illustrious and India's INS Virat demonstrated flexible operations with Harrier jets. While Italy's Giuseppe Garibaldi and Spain's Principe de Asturias brought European precision and compact efficiency. The Soviet Union answered with the massive Admiral Kuznetsov, combining heavy air power with missile systems in a uniquely Russian design. By 1990, the USS Abraham Lincoln represented the culmination of 70 years of carrier evolution. Nuclear-powered, jet-equipped, and capable of controlling the skies across any ocean. From the light carriers of 1945 to the nuclear supercarriers of 1990, these ships transformed from wartime experiments into the ultimate symbols of national power, shaping the modern world's balance at sea.